Greetings, fellow citizens. In this video, I want to talk about changes to shields between 3.5 and 3.6, and I will concentrate my video on size 1 shields, because this is already a lot to cover. This here is Moloko's 3.6 shield data, and as always, you can find a link to this in the video description below. And as you can see, there's tons of information, column after column, and I don't understand most of those values, so we have to concentrate on a few. Well, this is not your ultimate guide, this is just some hopefully interesting information for you. And here are the changes to shield HP the shield generators provide between 3.5 and 3.6. Size 0 shields, pin, no difference. Size 1 shields, shimmer got nerfed a bit, veil and ink and web are identical. Bulwark got a massive buff in shield HPs. Secure height, slight buff. Falco nerfed a lot. All stop, slight buff. Targa nerfed a lot and force wall, slight buff. Size 2 shields, Kimali, Aspis and Full Stop got a buff, Stop not. This is important, by the way, because Stop is the default shield of the Cutlass. And the 3 shields, Acura and Stronghold, not much of a difference in shield HPs between 3.5 and 3.6. And here are all the size 1 shields. That's a lot of data, don't fall asleep. I give you some cats. So what's important? In alphabetical order, damage delay, detection range, power consumption, regeneration rate and shield HPs. This column is number of shield HPs provided. This column is how many shield HPs are regenerated every second. And this column is regen delay damaged. When shields get damaged, when you are taking shield damage, I don't mean that the shield generator is getting damaged. When you are taking shield damage, your shields until 3.6 always regenerated unless they were down to zero. This changed in 3.6. In 3.6, size 0, size 2 and size 3 shields always regenerate when they are not down to zero with no delay. However, most size 1 shields have now a delay. For example, Falco, if you are taking shield damage, it takes 9.45 seconds where you don't receive any shield damage until your shields start to regenerate. But there are 4 shields with no delay, 4 size 1 shields with no delay. Cloak, Shimmer, Veil and Mirage. Next we are taking a look at shield regen time. This is the number of seconds to go from zero to full shields. Some shields are very, very quick, for example Shimmer, 9 seconds to go from zero to full shields, while Bulwark is a rather slow shield. It takes 53 seconds to go from zero to full shields. And next column is power draw per second. There's something like a rule, the more shield HPs a shield generator provides, the more power it needs, but it's not a strict rule. For example, Concord provide quite a bit of shield HPs but don't need that much power. No idea why, maybe because they are rather slow regenerating. And next we have detection range, and I am not sure which column in Moloko's data is telling you this exactly. I guess EM ratio and thermal energy draw, because those are the only columns that make sense. I mean, shields like Shimmer have a very low number, 3 and 5000, and Shimmers are stealthy shields, Veil 2, while shields like Bulwark are not stealthy and have a very high number. So I might be totally wrong here, and this has nothing to do with detection range, but I think it has. And if I'm correct, and if this has something to do with detection range, then there's still no way to tell what this actually means. I mean, Shimmers have a value of 5000, Bulwark 48000. This does not mean that your detection range is 4 times as long with bulwarks, I think. I tested this a little bit, I think, in 3.3 and 3.4, and yes, shimmers are stealthier than, for example, all stops, but the difference is not detection range that's 3 or 4 times as long. Would be very nice if someone knows how to translate those values into detection range in meters in game. Now this can be tested, but it has to be tested in the universe, because detection range in Arena Commander is very different from detection range in the universe. I noticed this when I did my tests in 3.3, I think. This would mean that you have at least 3 different detection ships to test, because we also have different radars, and you have to test 18, 19 different shields, so we are talking about best case scenario, no crashes, 6, 7, 8 hours testing and recording and editing. Not something I am willing to do right now, to be honest. Well, we have now a lot of data. How does this translate into a game? What should you do in game? Let's say you own a Super Hornet. The full shields of the Super Hornet are 2 all stops. Now you could put in 2 force walls. This way you get more shield HPs. It still takes only 20 seconds to go from zero to full shields. And you are even a little bit lower in delay, 4.55 seconds. Instead of 5.25 seconds. If I'm correct, and if this is about detection range, then your signature will be a tiny bit higher, but it shouldn't be much of a difference. I'm taking a wild guess here, maybe 100 meters at most. Again, if you have data, please tell us. We would be very interested. Or you could go all out and put in 2 bulwarks. This way you would have a lot more shield HPs, but it takes a lot longer to go from 0 to full shields. But your power consumption is identical, and your signature is identical, if I'm right, and this is about signature. Or you could go into the other direction, put in 2 shimmers. This way you would have no delay. You only would need 9 seconds to go from 0 to full shields, and you would be quite stealthy, I guess. However, you wouldn't have many shield HPs, so you most likely would be a one-hit kill for size 4 missile, surely for one size 5 torpedo. Now, what should you do? Should you put in a lot of shield HPs? Should you look for low signature? Should you look for low delay? Or should you look for faster regeneration rate? Well, it all depends on your playing style, on your skill, and what you are fighting. Let's say scenario 1. You are dogfighting, you are exchanging gunfire, and you are a good pilot, you are good at evading incoming fire, and you give your shields quite a lot of time in between the hits to regenerate. In this case, it would be much better to have a shield like all stop or maybe even shimmer that give you a lot of shield regeneration rate, and it doesn't matter much that you don't have that many shield HPs. And scenario B, you are in a high alpha damage scenario. You are getting shot at, missiles are fired, and you are taking quite a bit of damage. In this case, it would be much more important to have more shield HPs, and then it just doesn't matter that your shields are regenerating rather slowly, because if a Saber with 3 shimmers is hit by 1 size 5 torpedo and 3.6, she is gone. So no benefit from no delay and fast regeneration rate. And I had another idea, it's a crazy idea, it might work. Let's say you own a Saber, default loadout of the Saber are 3 size 1 shimmers. How about mix and matching? Put in 1 shimmer, 1 all stop and 1 bulwark. You should have 1 pool of shield HPs, and you still might benefit from the faster regeneration rate of the shimmers, or does this stop when the shimmers are full? This is something so crazy. I might test this. How long it takes to go from zero to full shields when having one shimmer, one all stop and one bulwark into my saber, and then same with three shimmers, three phosphors and three bulwarks. This could be very interesting. And the $1 million question, what should you go? Should you go, I want as many shield HPs as possible, or should you go, I want to be as stealthy as possible, or should you go, I want to have a good shield regeneration rate, but I still want to have at least a bit of shield HPs? Well, like I said, it depends a lot on your playing style, and I guess the best way for you is just to test, try different shield generators and find out what's best for you. If you like to, you can leave some comments and some questions and maybe we can find a solution, but I am in no way an expert. I'm just your average Joe. As always, I hope you had fun watching this video and see you next time. Bye. So let's kill the Cyclone AA. It has shields and full health. Fire. Well, this took a while. Maybe you have to hit a specific spot. This thing is still moving. It's Fender. Where are you going? Another one. I love this game. That's too funny. it's still moving. Maybe it's going back to Shubin. That's where I want to go.